I'm the director of electrophysiology at Harper University Hospital, and I'm also a professor of medicine at Wayne State School of Medicine. Sleep apnea has an impact on the total cardiovascular system of the patient. Atrial fibrillation is one specific aspect of the cardiovascular system or cardiovascular diseases. Therefore, in my practice, and in our cardiovascular metabolic center, we are very interested in identifying sleep apnea and its impact on multiple components of cardiovascular diseases. This can be on patients with hyperlipidemia, dyslipidemia. It can be on patients who are having resistant or difficult to treat hypertension. In all of our metabolic syndrome patients, we have a strong feeling that all these patients should be screened for sleep apnea. Atrial fibrillation, before we invoke upon any invasive treatments, all of our patients are screened for sleep apnea. 1 in 2 individuals in the United States will die from a cardiovascular disease. The incidence of sleep apnea when screened for in populations is probably as high as 50% in the adult population, and the sleep apnea syndrome, while less a percentage of it, significantly impacts quality of life and overall performance of life for patients. Therefore, it is absolutely critical that we do not think of sleep apnea as a treatment only for atrial fibrillation. The impact on why sleep apnea treatments will impact atrial fibrillation is not because it's impacting the AKG. It's because it's impacting the cardiovascular system to favor remodeling. The remodeling there that causes also heart failure, the remodeling that is caused in the lipid panel, the remodeling that leads to hypertension. It is all of these impacts on the cardiovascular system. It is not just on atrial fibrillation. With more and more data and more observational studies publishing that prevention of atrial fib by upfront treatment with sleep apnea, and the recommendations now that we should be treating post-AFib ablation, screening them for sleep apnea, I think that's going to be a very growing market, and I think also it's going to improve patient outcomes upfront, preventing them from having to go through an invasive procedure, and post-op, reducing the risk of reoccurrence and unnecessary procedures. In my dreams and my wishes, I would like to see a sleep study as part of the vital signs and statistics of what we do for people. Currently in the United States, we will push for lipids and for lipid treatments, yet common things, maybe treatment of sleep apnea may allow a larger impact than cholesterol management, especially primary prevention. Once we explain to the patient that identification of sleep apnea can lead to a better quality of life, or potentially better management of their cardiovascular disease component, then the question is, what type of sleep study? Patients are very reluctant to accept the information from an overnight sleep study outside their house. They will tell us they don't believe the data because they couldn't sleep, they weren't comfortable in their bed. When they have at home a sleep study done in their own bed, where it's minimally invasive, minimal amount of equipment, then they're much more open to accepting the diagnosis and the treatment.